Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. And in this video, we will discuss about SKUs, barcode and GTIN number. And I'm also going to tell you how you can add GTIN number to your Shopify products. So SKUs is basically which works internally on your store. So you might have a SKU code format, which might be similar to other stores, but if you talk about the barcode and if you talk about the GTIN numbers, then it has to be unique globally. So it's mostly used by the resellers. They are shipping products on your behalf. It's helpful to find the product inventory by the use of GTIN numbers. GTIN stands for Global Trade Item Number. So you don't have to mix both of these. These are two separate things. Again, SKU, which you can use on your store, and it doesn't have to be globally matched. But if you talk about the GTIN number, then the reseller, whoever is selling you the products, the GTIN number in your store and the reseller who is selling you the products should be matched and should be same. So basically it's an international trade number, which is used to identify the products which you have in your store. There's a lot more information which you can find in Shopify Help Center. I'll put the link of that article in the YouTube video description so you can read more about SKUs, stock keeping units, GTIN number, global trade item number. Now, let's see where we can add GTIN numbers on our Shopify store, because when we go to the backend, it doesn't actually say GTIN number. It basically says something else, which let me show you what. So as you can see that on my screen, I have the Shopify development store open where I'm going to show you guys where you need to add GTIN numbers, global trade item number, or SKU stock keeping unit, right? So that's the product section on our Shopify store. And these are some of the sample products which I have added in order to show you guys how it's going to work. So let's click on any of the product. For example, this is the first of the product. And if we scroll down, and so here's the option where we can see the inventory of all of the items, all of the variants in our products. And let's click on edit. And here you can see we can add SKUs of all of the variants available in this product. Now the question is where you will add the GTIN number, which is global trade item number. So global trade item number will be added on the barcode section because it's a form of barcode. So GTIN is actually a barcode, which you can say. So there are multiple standards of GTIN. It's GS1 and there are multiple standards. Again, I'll put the link of a blog post in this video description where you can read all of the details about GTIN numbers. Now for SKUs, we will edit the SKU section by going to our inventory and this edit button here. And for GTIN number, we will just add that on our barcode section. So there's no actual separate section for GTIN. It's within the barcode as it's a form of barcode. So we'll simply add in the number, whatever we have. So basically it's normally from 11 to 13 on some GS1 standard is 12 digit barcode GTIN number. And if you go to some other standards, there are multiple standards of GTIN number where they have multiple, where they have different length of the GTIN numbers. So you can simply fill in the details of the GTIN number for the specific variant. And once you add that, just click on that and hit save to add that. Okay, guys, that's it for the video. So my customer requested me about the GTIN number, that where I'll add the GTIN number. And initially I didn't even know about that. So I studied via some blog post and from the Shopify website. And I thought that I should share this knowledge with you guys as well, that what are the GTIN numbers and how should we use the GTIN number in our Shopify store. So that's it for the video, guys. And hopefully you would like it. If you do, let us know in the comments below and let us know what more you would like to learn about the Shopify web design development and any and whatever stuff you would like to learn in this channel. Until next video, have a great day.